this tutorial, I will show you how to use a device library. In the previous tutorial, I told you that this type of library contains not only the function block, but also support masks, protocols, the Modbus templates, and so on. So they correspond more or less to the OneTool modules. In this tutorial, I will use the CPCOE. I will also move the water inlet temperature from the U1 terminal of the CPCO to the U1 terminal of the CPCOE, so we can also test the communication between them. Well, if you know OneTool, you know that use blocks like this is very simple. Just it is a matter of a drag and drop from the library to a strategy page. Here in C Suite, at least at the moment, it is not so quick, so fast, because there is a sequence of operations that you have to do. It is not complicated, it is only a matter of do this operation in this sequence without skip some of them. So we can start with this part regarding strategy. So we have to add the library to the project, confirm all the proposals and build. So we can download from KSA in the library section, search for the block, the support block. Here is the CPCOE. This is suitable for a C Suite 3.0.41 or greater, so that's good. Download. Then edit to the project, so right click, add the dependency. If you remember, in the very first project we have added the Karel basic lib. Now we have to add the Karel basic lib. Is already in a place where C Suite is able to find it, while the library that we have downloaded is somewhere else, so we have to browse. It is in the downloads. This is today. These are previous examples. Open. Here is a CPCOE version 1.3.1. Okay. And confirm all the proposals. What are the proposals? There is. Because this library contains not only the block and the masks and Modbus protocols, but also contains a program POU, something like this, that is a page, a POU, a page, containing the function block in subject and also some support strategy. It also contains a LAMS, in this case not contains global variables. So, as told before, just accept it. So, here is the POU containing the function block for the CPCOE and some support strategy around. So, this is the core function block, and also there are some support function blocks. And then build. Okay, succeeded. So step one done. Step two is in CMask, so we have to import the worksheet. This is a worksheet containing the support masks for the CPCOE. We have also to select the strategy POU that we have just imported in CStrategy, because we have to bind the variables of the masks with the variables of that CPCOE, because we may have 2, 3, 4 CPCOE. So we have to bind the masks with the correct function block in the strategy. So in the layout, right click, import worksheet template. The system automatically open the place where is the file. So just select the name of the function block that we are using. That is the CPCOE. That is the CPCOE 2 version 131. Okay, enter and just select the file and bind with what? With this POW CPCOE and NG. So let's search for CPCOE and NG. Here it is. Then confirm all. Confirm, finish. So here is the imported worksheet with the support masks of the CPCOE. Now we should move these masks from this page to one of the other pages. For example, in the devices, we could use the device to loop, for example, for the CPCOE. But I won't do that in this tutorial. Now we have to update the alarms, the description of the alarms, as we've done in the tutorial 16. This block has two alarms, has added these two alarms, device offline alarm and wrong configuration on device. So we have to update the classes. The description and the number. Well, here we can just add other two alarm 03 and 4, while for the description I can use this one. It is too long. Long config on device. Okay, and then build. Okay, that's all for the step number 2. The step 3 is in C design. We have to import the protocol templates. The point is that the CPCOE communicates with CPCO in Modbus. CPCOE is the slave, CPCO is the master. We have already seen in the tutorial 19 how to manage Modbus master. We have to create a list, the list of the variables that the master exchanges with the slave. Well, the point is that here, or now, we don't have to create that list from scratch, because the list of the variables is already in a file. So we have, let's say, simply to import that list that is called templates. When we import the templates, we have to select also the function block that manages that CPCOE, because we may have 2, 3, 4, 5 CPCOE. So each list that we import has to be bound to a specific function block in the strategy. Well, let's do it. Let's open CDesign. Let's select the configuration, chill for compressors, protocols. So we can remove the line that we have created in the previous exercise. Oh, actually, we can leave it. We can just use change the address. So we have to import template. Like before, the system opens the folder where are the files. So open the folder. There are a lot of files. We used a naming convention for which the files for Modbus Master are called the name of the device, CPKOI in this case, and MBM for Modbus Master. This is for Karel Master Protocol. So now, in this exercise, we will use Modbus. So we have not just one list, but four. This, 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 and this. So we have to repeat what we are doing four times, one for each file. Okay, start with this, open, and then bound with the function block for the first CPKOI. In this case, it is in the CPKOI MNG, CPKOI E21. So, CPKOI MNG, that is the name of the PO, this one. CPKOI 21 is the name of the instance, that is this. So select it. So it is not difficult, just pay attention to the name of the POU and the name of the function block. Okay, this is the first. So repeat for the second. The third, and the last. Okay. Well, just for curiosity, we can see that now the variables involved for this CPKOI are variables of the CPKOI MNG POU, CPKOI 21 instance and ENIO table variable. CPKOI POU, CPKOI 21 instance, and it was one of these input and output. Okay, save. Well, that's all for the step number 3. Is quite all regarding the import. What do we have to do to manage more CPKOI? So for the second, third or fourth CPKOI, the sequence is more or less the same. For the CMask CDesign is exactly the same. For CStrategy is a little bit different. But we want to do this in this exercise. Well, I have imported all what is necessary to manage the CPKOI. What I have done is generic and it is common for all the device type libraries. Anyway, some device library may need something specific. So I strongly recommend you to read the user manual of the library before to start to add it to your project. Well, now let's continue with our exercise, because I told you that I want to move the water inlet temperature sensor from an input of the PICO, CPICO, to an input of the CPKOI. So, first of all, we have to disconnect the variable temperature. Here is disconnect from an input of the CPKO. No, is null. So disconnect from the CPKO because later we have to connect somehow to the CPKOI. Save. So this is the support function block for the CPKOI. So somehow we have to pass to this block the status of the digital output and analog output we want to send to the CPCOE, and in the other side this block returns the values of the input, analog input and digital input of the CPCOE. We have to make some space. Well, this block receives the status of the output, digital and analog output, from an input that is this one. I already know that this is the input, but in your case you should read the manual. So F1. Devices, CPCOE. So here in this manual you can find the description of the input, the output, so what we have to read to write in order to read write the input and the output. Well, I know that is that one. Actually, we can go and see the input val in CPCOE, the values to be sent to the CPCOE. Only the outputs are considered because it is a common structure for the input and the output. So in this case we have to consider only the input. So we have to send to the CPCOE what the variable compressor 1, compressor 2, 3 and 4. And copy somewhere in this structure, so enter. This is a structure containing information for the regarding the input and the output. We just read in the manual that we have to consider the outputs, so the status of the first output is this. Copy from the other. Second output. Third. Compressor 1, the out 1, compressor 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4. Well, I have also to enable the block. Attention, this is not a training on the CPCOE. It's a training how to use the device library. So I don't tell you more information about this block. So I have enabled the block. Pass the status of the relay to the structure containing the output of the CPCOE. In the other side, basically is the opposite. The same but the opposite. So this is the value input, these are the value output. So from here, from this or through this structure, the system returns the value of the input coming from the CPCOE. In this case we have to read an input. First, I told you that I want to use the first of the 10 universal channel of the CPCOE, so this one, and that will be written to the water temperature. So you see that this variable is takes a value not in CDesign, that is from an input of the CPCOE, but from the CPCOE. Okay, I check again the output block enable. read input. That's all. Now I can build. Okay, succeeded. Build. Okay, I already built before. And then I have to upload. Ten, ten, one, two. Well, I have uploaded the software into the CPICO. Now the CPICO E is connected to CPICO to the Fieldbus 2. I moved the probe simulator from the CPICO to the CPICO Mini. So now the temperature is here. Let's check. Now is a 12, is a 14.2. Reduce 13. 12. You notice that there is a double click, because the first click is a click is a relay in the CPICO E, the other click is the relay in the CPICO, because probably you notice that I didn't remove compressor 1234 from the CPICO E. For this reason they are both active. Okay, the temperature changes, so it works. Well, that's all for this tutorial, where we have seen how to add a device library into a project. I remind you once again that in KSA there is a specific document that explains in detail all the operations you can do with a library and with a block of a library. Thank you for watching.